My name is Richard Sterzica. I'm a research scientist with CSIRO. And my job is working out how to turn water into food. For 20 years, I've been working in Africa, working with small-scale farmers, and I lead a project for ACR, the Australian Centre for International Agricultural Research, helping small-scale irrigators to get more food for less water. And I'm going to show you how this can help you in your backyard today. This is a tap timer. You've probably got one in your garden. It's got two knobs. One asks you, how often are you going to water? Every day, every 3 days, every 7 days. This one says how long? For 5 minutes, half an hour, 2 hours. It's a decision we all make, but none of us have any information upon which to make it. And that's where the chameleon card comes in. So we work with farmers from many countries who speak many languages, and even if they're illiterate, everybody can speak the language of colour and can understand the patterns that colours make. And we start here by making a completely new sensor. But more than that, we had to make a new language to talk about this stuff, a language of colour, where the colours have meaning and the colours are linked to action. So when the sensor reads blue, it means your soil is wet. If you don't irrigate for a few days, your sensor will turn green. And if you don't irrigate again, it will turn red, at which point the plant is probably stressed and you will be losing yield. This is about as simple as soil water monitoring gets. I have a sensor buried down here in this broccoli 20 centimeters down. I get my chameleon card, press the button, slip the wire onto the contacts, and you see the light sits green. And that means that there's enough water here for these broccoli. I'll probably have to water in a day or two's time. Next door I have a row of beans. I do the same thing, press the button, slip the wire onto the contact, and it's reading blue, which means it's wet. And I certainly don't need to irrigate here. Now, if I was a small-scale farmer in Africa and I had half a hectare of beans that took all day to irrigate, I haven't just saved water, I've saved a whole day that I can do something else. Over the last 10 years, we've worked with thousands of farmers across Africa, and we've been amazed at how much water they have saved and grown more food at the same time. Same for me here in this garden. I save a huge amount of water. But turning water into food is a serious business, and we invite you to get involved.